So as we start getting into coding using Spark Streaming, let us understand what is required to do so. So Spark Streaming need to have a web service so that streaming context can keep on polling the web service at regular intervals and get the data from there. To simulate that, we can use NC. NC stands for Netcat, and it will be available on Linux or Mac. If not, you have to set up. If it is Mac or Linux, if it is already available, you can use command called nc-lk and pass the port number. Then it will start a web service which can be pinged using telnet. So I'm opening another tab here. I can say telnet localhost 9999 and hit enter. Okay, telnet is not there on my Mac. So let me say nc localhost 9999. So hyphen lk is to create a web service, and just using NC we can interact with the web service. You can see here, so NC hyphen lk 9999. Earlier there is nothing, and then I've opened another tab and say NC localhost 9999 and type hello world. If there is telnet, we can also say telnet localhost 9999, and then we can enter something here which will be printed here. So this is nothing but a web service running on port number 9999. We can interrupt that and we can send messages using NC or telnet to it to just validate that our web service is up and running. If it is a Windows, the commands are a bit different, and also Windows might not have out of the box, hence we need to understand how to set up. So just go to the browser and search for Netcat on Windows. So there is one thing here, you can click on this and you can download. You can just click on this and it will download the zip file. Once it is downloaded, you can I have two, so I'm deleting one. You can copy this to whatever path you want. So I would like to put it in C drive. Okay, no need to copy the entire directory. I can just open that zip file and then copy the directory netcat 1.11 and then paste it here. And then let me clean up this zip file. Okay, so Netcat is available on your PC. Now to run commands such as NC from wherever you want, you have to set the environment variable. So here I'm going to environment variables and I have to update the path, which is a system variable. I can click on new and then browse and then go to the location where the netcat is available, and we have to choose the netcat directory from the location where it is copied to, and then click on OK, click on OK, click on OK. Let's close these things which were already there. I'm also closing Cygwin. Now either you can use Cygwin or DOS prompt, whatever it is, and then you can say NC and hit enter to just confirm that it works, and then you can kill the session. You can also issue commands after typing NC in the command line. You can issue commands, but I will be issuing commands directly, and we can say hyphen L hyphen P. In Mac or Linux we have to use NC minus LK. Here it has to be hyphen P. Okay, and then give the port number. I have given with 49s. And then I'm opening a new Cygwin console. And then I can either run telnet if the telnet is installed. Telnet is already installed, so I can use it here. And I can type hello world here, and you will see the message. Okay, it is not getting for some reason. Let me see. If I say NC localhost 9999, Okay, there is some issue. So let me try with DOS prompt, or let me see nc.exe localhost 9999. No, it is not working. .exe. Ideally, it should have shown here. Let me try using regular command prompt rather than sigwin. Okay, nc hyphen l hyphen p 9999. And then I'm opening another one. Nc hyphen, there's no need to pass any hyphen. I can just say localhost 9999. Hello world. Interesting. Or let me say nc 9999. Okay, when I kill it, it is coming. I don't know why. Typically, it should come immediately, but for some reason, it is only coming when I kill it. With Windows, some of these things actually behave a bit weird. Let me try once again. Yeah, so earlier, the cursor is like this, and it actually bothered the stuff. So now I will, kill the session and relaunched it. And now I can say, hello world, how are you? We will be running Spark streaming jobs against this very soon. Okay, so it is working as expected. So this is how you can set up NC. Now we can actually create our Spark streaming job to connect to this web service and then pass messages like this. And then we'll be processing this data. And we will see that as we explore the Spark streaming by writing the code to process this kind of data in streaming fashion.